Okay, it's March 15th, the Ides of March. It's 1:54 p.m. Central Time. And I'm going to show you, I've been out here very painfully, too. Tilling up my garden. I've gotten that tiller to work. I think it's coming out pretty good. Let me put down the camera a little bit for a second, because I have it on a tripod and I had it set to have it at a higher level than I wanted it, because I'm carrying it. I can't carry it and look in the viewfinder while it's so high up. So as you can see, the tiller is actually working. And I came over here a little bit further, about another 2.5 to 3 feet. You saw the earlier video where the dead grass was. This side here, I don't know if I'm going to go over that far, because I'm going to put a natural compost bin right out here. The only thing that's not going to be natural would be actually 2x4s I'm going to use, I'm going to buy to get. And like I had those branches right there, broken branches, set up like in a little L. I've got sunglasses on, so I can't really see really good in this viewfinder. I know I'm pretty much right in the composting. But yeah, here's the yell. As well, I have my watermelon, primarily watermelon and cantaloupe, and maybe beans. So again, I can't really see the sunrise out here. I mean, the sunrise, the screen out here with the sun in my face. And I have sunglasses on now, which I don't wear too often. But you can see how I tore it all up here. Not tore it up, tilled it all up. Tore it up, whatever you want to say. The main garden, you can see the soil looks much richer. Even though after a day or so, it'll look nice and tan, because the top of it will dry, the top layer will dry out. I just started to make rows. I thought, well, why don't I get the camera out here and videotape a little bit just to show you. And then, see, now this little square over here are going to go same direction. So I'll have one, two, three, four, maybe five, if I use one right up on the edge over here. If I even dig up one more row over, half a row over, to make a fifth row for planting. And then the garden itself, I should have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven rows, of which I'm going to just plant every other one. Okay, so I'll have four rows of vegetables growing here. All heirloom seeds, so they have not been genetically modified to grow stronger, to kill insects, so that I can eat the food that's killing off other bugs, other insects, other living sources. If you think about that stuff, if it's insect resistant or disease resistant, it's just more chemicals you're eating. Guys, understand that that's an old tiller right there too, but it's doing the purpose, you know, it's serving the purpose big time. It's a big help too. I did about 80%, not even close to what I'm doing right now with this thing. I've gone down the whole garden probably about 4 to 6 inches, and it's rough still a little bit, but sure as hell beats doing it all by with a hand pole and a bull rake. So again, that's the garden. I've gone across it. I'm going to finish this up in the middle part there. I haven't gone crossways in the very middle right here. It's about 4 to 5 hour trips back and forth right here in the middle. But after I do that, I'll go back and up. I made them 1-2 rows over there, but that's not the rows. That was just, I want to see how it would look for spacing. You know, because this is the front tine, and like I said, with being old, you can't put it in neutral and drive it. It's just regular wheels that you push. So I have to pick up that I can't remember the term no more. The little pointy thing that makes my rows. I have to pick that up. And then I got two rows here. And that's not even how it's gonna be though. I just want to see how it would look. So try to get yourself a little piece of dirt someplace and grow you about four to six vegetables. You got no excuses for it anymore. It's not gonna get much better. I told you when I'm out here, this is on 90% of the time. I mean, I had it off earlier for a little bit, but then I put it on because I'm breathing all the stuff that shoots up. Even though this is a lot more, I'm taking this thing off for right now. The heat is building a little bit, and like I said, this is a little bit better than a lot of other places. The sky is the sky, and the chemtrails and such will fall everywhere. But again, this is much better, more fertile land than a lot around here. Even the farmland around me, the owner of this property here, farms all this farmland around me. Probably about 800 or plus acres, maybe 1,000 acres over on that side there. All that land, all the way to the back over there, over the trees, that hill. There's a road back there. All that land over there, all that up to the tree line. All that, all the way over there on the other side. You saw the corn last year. It was Monsanto corn, which that's the reason I won't be growing any more corn over here. But, like I said, this is a pretty decent little piece here that I can on a fruit garden. I haven't measured it yet. The very next video that I do, I will have a tape measure out here, and I will measure this. I'm going to say right now 45 feet by, in the first part, by about 22 feet. And then that little extension over there, that little L, I call it the L. It's the little add-on part in the back there where a watermelon and a cantaloupe and all are going to go. That's about 15 by 15. So, like I said, I'll get the exact measurements and put it on here next time. So, everybody, stay safe. Get some food. Get your water filter. Get you some silver. Might have to get a gas mask pretty soon if you look at the sky there. Yeah, it's all chemtrails, man. Look at that. That's all chemtrail. All chemtrail. See all that? It's all chemtrails up in the sky, man. Look, there's one of the little pricks up there. Where I don't know if I can see them in here. I just see them by the going into the tree up there. Right above the tree. Yeah. Motherfucker. You know, everybody, no one gets out alive. Everybody's going to pay for everything they've done. So I would just like to be the one to wash their faces if they realize, what do you mean I have to, what? Yeah, you're going to have to be punished for that. Going to hang you 18 inches off the ground, let your body hang for about, 3 weeks, 3 days and 3 hours. That's going to be the standard. 3 weeks, 3 days and 3 hours. 18 inches off the ground. Don't break their neck. Just hoist them up and let them lay there. Or hang there. Okay, folks. You guys have a great day. Be peaceful and take care of your families. Grow some food.